Gentlemen, we have a super exclusive. We are aboard the INS Vishakhapatnam, which is to be inducted into the Indian Navy today. Republic is the first channel to be on board the vessel. Here it is. We are in the at the bow of the ship, that is the front of the ship, and we are showing you visuals of the main deck here in front of us here. This is the main cannon of the ship. It is a 76 millimeter cannon, but this is not the main armament of the ship. This is a destroyer, a stealthy guided missile destroyer that is capable of waging war on all fronts. Behind it, you can see the main deck and bridge, the communications tower. Also there, you see these circular structures. These circular structures are the surface-to-air missile systems. So this is a ship, the INS Vishakhapatnam, which is capable of waging war against targets in the air, against targets on the ground, that is surface-based targets, as well as targets that are on the sea, as well as underwater, that is submarines. So to fight submarines, which are the scourge of ships such as this, it has the capability of launching torpedoes as well as anti-submarine rockets. It has a serious amount of communications array, and it also has incredible radar capabilities. For underwater, it has sonar capabilities as well, as ships of its class do. The INS Vishakhapatnam is the first of four ships in its class, and Republic is the first on board. As you can see beyond it, on the other side, on the dock, this is the Mumbai docks. On the other side is the event that has just started, where this vessel will be commissioned into the Indian Navy. We are awaiting the arrival of Defence Minister Rajnath Singh, but we have got a sneak peek aboard the vessel. As you can see, we are showing you a scale model of the ship. There are some fineries on display because this is a very important day and a very special day for the Indian Navy. We are going to show you also the front of the ship. That is where we are. So this is exactly the bow of the ship. You can see this enormous chain in front of me. That is its anchor. From below, while we were reporting earlier, we had showed you the anchor right at the front of the ship. So just take a look at the size of these chains. That is how big a vessel this is. It's a 163 meter long vessel. That is seriously long for a ship of this class. For a destroyer, 163 meters is very, very long. It is the largest ship of its class in India. It has been developed indigenously under a project called Project 15B. Project 15B essentially entailed the construction of a stealthy guided missile destroyer that was largely made in India. All the steel that has been used in this has been developed in India, has been smelted in India. All the materials have been are indigenous. There is 75% Atmanirbharta entailed here. There are serious sophisticated weapons on board and communication systems on board. And this ship has been done up, including the paint. In fact, the paint is also advanced. It is a stealthy paint that makes this ship difficult to detect. So for an enemy ship, this one may look very small. It may look like nothing more than a fishing boat, but in effect, it is a huge warship that is capable of a number of activities. It can take up missions that can stretch as long as 45 days. It's called the ship's endurance. The ship's endurance is 45 days, and 45 days is conservative. If required, the INS Vishakhapatnam can go beyond that. If it needs to take up missions in the deep blue sea, it can be outfitted to go even beyond that. 300 crew members will be a part of its complement. So 300 sailors can live aboard this ship for periods extending up to 2 months. We are giving you exclusive first visuals of the INS Vishakhapatnam. It is a serious advancement and a serious augmentation to the Indian Navy's capabilities. This is the first shots we are getting of the interior of the ship. These are exclusive visuals. Republic TV is the first on board the INS Vishakhapatnam. It has been built here by the Mazagon Dock Limited after having been designed by the Naval Design Academy, which is the most advanced design academy of the Indian Navy. This is one of the most important additions, the indigenous additions, but there are even more coming. The INS Vishakhapatnam very swiftly will be followed by a submarine called the INS Vela, which will be inducted just a few days from now. And apart from destroyers and submarines, the really big addition, the INS Vikrant aircraft carrier, the indigenous aircraft carrier IAC-1, is also undergoing trials and is inching closer and closer to commissioning. So this is a very significant and very important day for the Indian Navy. You can see that every inch of this ship is outfitted with different capabilities. You can almost look at it and you can see what it's used for. There are PA systems, there are surface-to-air missile cannons. There is a very large communications array. There is a very, I'm told, there is a very powerful intra-ship communication setup as well. inside, I can imagine there are sonar systems where there would be sailors listening in to what is going on underwater. This is a ship that can really bolster India's capabilities because it can take on targets that are in the air with its surface-to-air missiles. It can take on targets that are on the ground with its surface-to-surface missiles. It can take on other ships and it can take on submarines as well. Submarines are the scourge of these kind of ships generally, but this has a complement of torpedoes as well as anti-submarine rockets that can be used to take on submarines. So we are aboard the INS Vishakhapatnam. There you can see the plaque, and very shortly the Defense Minister Rajnath Singh is going to be here, and he is going to christen this ship, and he is going to induct it and commission it into the Indian Navy. This is a very august day for the Indian Navy. The event that is going on, it's been done up in all kinds of finery. It's really wonderful to see the forces and the officers and the sailors of the Indian Navy in their white, sparkling white uniforms. It is a fantastic setup that they've done here, and it is befitting the occasion, because the INS Vishakhapatnam is going to really bolster the Indian Navy's capabilities and also the confidence that we are capable of designing and building and constructing a ship of this class, of this significance, of this capability, build it with indigenous components, with indigenous materials. That is a real boost for not only the Navy, but for the nation as a whole, for the nation's capabilities, for its forces, for its manufacturing, for how it is perceived globally. So that is what this ship means. That is why this day is so important. And Republic TV, the first aboard, to get you the visuals and a walkthrough and a guided tour of the INS Vishakhapatnam. Back to you.
Ankit, thank you for that very detailed report. You are telling us a lot of features of this INS Vishakhapatnam and the submarine Vela as well. You have talked about how the surface-to-air missile system and also how it can tackle threats above and below water as well. I would request you to pan your camera a little bit more, because I believe you're the only journalist on board and you're getting us exclusive visuals. You're getting a very exhaustive, detailed report from on board of the INS Vishakhapatnam. I would want you to pan your camera a little bit more. I would want you to talk to me a little bit more about what exactly is expected today, and also about the features. Clearly, you have a lot of knowledge about what is happening on board of the INS Vishakhapatnam, and also the features that it also has with respect to the commissioning, in fact, of the INS Vishakhapatnam that is going to take place today as well. Walk our viewers through it, and I would want you to pan your camera as much as possible, since Ankit, I believe you are the only journalist on board.
Absolutely. We are the only ones on board. Vijay Mukkot and I are on board, and we are just showing you. This is the Mazagon Dock Limited, and here is where we are. That you can see is the main gun right there. You can see the main gun, a 76 mm gun. Behind it on the next deck, you can see the circular surface-to-air missile launching turrets. Beyond that is the main bridge where you see the windows. That's where the captain of the ship, that is going to be Captain Benz, he is going to commandeer the ship from up there. That is called the bridge of the ship. Behind it is the communications deck and the communications tower. You can see there are many, many different components, Priyanka, that even I do not know. Even I don't know. But we would also like to speak to some of the officers. We will try and get them also, but right now I don't think that they can talk because the event is ongoing. We've got a sneak peek on board. I can try and guesstimate that some of the golden colored things that you can see over there, those are likely to be lights, but we'll find out that also. We'll maybe ask some of the officers to tell us a little bit. There are different components of the ship which I am just finding out about right now. We are told that we are out of time here, Priyanka, because this was an exclusive walkthrough that we were allowed, and we thank the Indian Navy for it. But because the program is about to begin, we are slightly running out of time here, but we will try and be aboard here again. Republic TV, the first to be on board the INS Vishakhapatnam, and the first to tell you why it is so important for the Navy and why it is so important for the nation, Priyanka. This is a big, big win. Back to you in the studios.
Well, yes, Ankit there, our colleague on the ground, the only journalist on board of the INS Vishakhapatnam, getting us a very, very exhaustive and detailed report, Ankit. Thank you very much for that. I'll keep coming back to you as and when the event also starts.